Hello everyone, this is BCS Buster. Welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy VI. Well, last time we got a plan together to go and head to the sealed gate and see if we can get the espers to help us take on the Empire. We also went and got Mog on our team, and now he's in our party and ready to go. So all there is left to do now is head to the sealed gate and see if we can't get the espers to help us out, join our team. So, to get to the sealed gate, we go here. We want to land the airship right over here. There's a small little outpost here. And we'll just head right over here. I believe they said this was an Imperial observation post. But why aren't there any guards? Yeah. Usually if you come here, there's soldiers walking all about. And if you try to talk to any of them, you get into a random battle. Well, that's no good. Alright, so all we want to do is just mosey right on past. And head right over here. The cave to the sealed gate. Now, if you tried to come here earlier in the game, I believe this area, you can't access this area, and there's a plot wall that kind of just puts you here. You can't get here until you get to this point. To start off the cave, we get an assassin's dagger. Ooh. I believe only Locke can equip it, so we're not even going to worry about that for right now. So let's get down this way. Get to the first floor of this cave. And we get a Kazakiri, which is a weapon for Cyan, I believe. So, not too worried about that. And we got some new enemies here. Outcast. Oh, God. I hate these freaking things. But if we have Gaia Gears, we're actually going to be in good shape. These guys have an attack called Life Shaver, which can severely damage you. I'm believing. I'm sure you'll get a chance to see it a little bit later on. But what we want to do is we want to use the... And most of the time in here, we're going to be using... where is it? Anguiform. And for Mog, we want to use the Water Harmony Dance. And for Terra... Look at that. Woohoo! Yeah, that's awesome. By the way, you see that Terra... Oh, Mog wouldn't regen. Good. That Terra has an ability now called Trance. And what that does... It doubles her attack power and magic power for a limited time. But it's actually not incredibly useful. Oh, he's all done with that. Okay. Let's give him done with that. It doesn't really matter. How about pizza? Sure. It doesn't really do a whole lot of effect now, but it will be much, much more important later on in the game. Okay. Now here, we've got a little puzzle room here. If you step on the tiles, they change places there, you see. I want to go here first. Over. There we go. And in this chest, we get a Heiji's Jeet. I think that's a helmet. There might be a relic. I don't know. Well, I'll look it up here in a second. Oops, nope. Yeah. And if you accidentally step on the lava, you get booted back to the beginning. So we don't want that. So let's go up here now. Wait for that to go over. And face off against another new enemy, Antares. Same thing, just go with water attacks for the most part in this cave. That's going to be your the way to go. And let's use the Water Harmony Dance to see if we get that going with Mog. Yeah, Gao and Mog are going to be so useful in this area. And we get an X Potion, cool. I want to say that is a relic. That Heiji's whatever. And I think it changes the, if you have Setzer, it changes the slot command to Gil, so he throws money at his opponents. But we'll worry more about that later. Here. And down, and we're out of this area. Very good. All right, now here's where things start to get confusing. Let's see. I'm gonna go this way. Face off against another new enemy here, Zombie Dragon. Now, these things are dead enemies, so in this case, let's use the Twilight Requiem in this case. Because we'll be able to do a lot of damage to these things. And for magic, do you have life? Yeah, look at that. Woohoo! I believe you can cast haste on these guys. and kill them. Since I believe they're dead enemies, since they're zombies. Yep. Very good. So that cave-in is a pretty good ability, as it reduces their HP by like 3/4, I think. And then we can just use them to finish off there. So, yeah, no problem. Very good. Ooh, and Gal learned level. Ooh, and he gained Thundara. Excellent. We can probably swap that out now. Who did he have? Remu? Okay, let's swap that out with... Again, it really doesn't matter at this point. I got most of his abilities learned on the Veldt, getting levels. So that was pretty cool. Alright, now this way. And we get a high ether. Very good. Okay, now let's see if we can get these. Okay, cool. Now, if the dance works, you'll switch terrains, as you can see, and all of a sudden be transported to a different area. So that's kind of a nice little touch. Now, I'm showing this fight because I want to see if they'll do their attack, their Lifesaver attack. Which does a ton, like, it can do almost 1,000 damage to your characters. It's basically a life drain attack, but if you have Gaia gear... Oh, very good. If you have Gaia gear, the effect is reversed, and you gain the HP, and they lose it. So that's good. Okay, Raspin Osmos. Oh, let's give him Zone Seeker so she can finish off with that Esper. All right, very good. Now we'll go down this way, and over here, I believe. Aha! Yeah, we can sneak through there. All right, and after that level... Terra naturally learned the Raze spell. So, even without an Esper, she would have learned that. So that's going to be very helpful a little bit later on. Okay, so now let's go this way and up here. And what do we got over here? Okay, now here's that Lifesaver attack I was talking about. Yeah, see how that works there? Now, fortunately... We were able to get that to work. And since we had Gaia gear on, we absorbed it, as opposed to having the life sucked out of us. Now, if that would have worked, Gal would have probably lost around 700 HP, and that would have sucked. But all was right with the world, and we prevailed there. Okay. Shell, I don't really care about that, but I do care about... Okay, let's get her going on some level... Well, she can learn level 2 fire magic naturally. So, let's get her going with... Yeah, let's get her going with Ramu there. Very good. Okay, now go over here. Crap! Oh, God, she landed on her face! Ouch! Okay, well, anyways, there's a distant sound. Ooh. Alright, now I believe... Let's see. I'm gonna go this way first. Ah, there we go. And we get another Genji Glove! Really. The Genji Glove is going to be an outstanding relic later in the game. It's still useful now, but it's going to be even more useful later on in the game. All right, very good. Ooh, okay, I want to show you this one. El Nino. Woohoo! Look at that damage. Yeah, that happens rarely, but when it does happen, man, it deals a ton of damage. So, yeah, I'm a big fan of that one. Okay, he's almost done with his Asuna, too. So this is good. We're actually making really good progress. Yeah, we're actually doing pretty well. And this is actually, it can be a pretty difficult cave if you don't know what you're doing. And really, Gaia gears are the best part about all this. Okay, now we have some switches here. So let's see, what we want to do... let's open this door first. Aha! And we go up here. Ooh, there's a save point. And we get a tent. Very nice. So if you ever need to restore your MP, you can do that. I've used some MP with Edgar to cast Raze on those zombie dragons. So, you know what? I'm actually going to wait. I'm not going to open that just yet. I want to throw this switch first. Uh-oh. It's a guy from Zozo. And this is another new enemy here, the ninja. This guy is deadly. He will kick you. Ooh, he will kick your ass. Now, fortunately, I'm ready to deal with him. So let's definitely try and get instant death on him. That would be very nice. And that didn't work so well. Let's go with Water Harmony. That's fine. Apparition. And I think this is a single targeting attack. Oh, no. Uh-oh. Don't kill me. Yeesh. All right. Let's see if I can finish this guy off. I'm definitely going to need to heal after this one. All right. Come on. Go team. Come on. Finish him off. Whew. I think that guy has like 2,000 HP, so that guy is deadly. Didn't watch out for him, but... Haha! Claim all the treasure beneath the ground, beneath the big stairway from my own. Okay, remember that here for just a little bit. I'm definitely gonna use a tent here, because that was... Ooh, that sucked. And I have a lot of tents, so it's fine. Yeah, we'll be seeing ninjas a lot later in the game. Alright, very good. And you can save your game if you want. Now, let's throw the switch. And it throws a little stairway there. Alright, let's go down this way. Now we go take this chest up here. Ah, okay. So there's that apparition attack, and what that does, as you can see, is that confuses an opponent, which can be nice if my stupid idiot Gao would not have hit him in the face. Yeah. That's right. I've actually had quite a high amount of success with Water Harmony in this area. I haven't missed yet, which is nice. Sometimes Mog can miss, and if Mog misses, then he just lands on his face and it says failed, and you basically wasted a turn. So, you don't want to do that. Okay, so let's get him going on... That doesn't really matter. How about Ifrit? Sure. Now, can someone else use Seraph? Yeah, I'm gonna get her going on Seraph. There we go. She can start working on some cure spells, which would be good for her. And we get a high ether, very nice. Okay. Now, I want to show you something real quick. Now, you'll notice here that this stairway is a grand stairway, if you will. So, if you go over here, one step down, one step from the bottom of the stairs, something is buried here. And we get an invisibility scroll, so that's kind of cool. Now, watch this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Something is buried here. And we get a gold needle. Very nice. Okay, let's see. Now we want to go... You know, I forgot to get one up here. Go up here. Go up here. 1, 2, 3. We get 293 gil. That's not bad. It's better than nothing. If we go up here, let's see. 1, 2, 3. Maybe it's here. There it is. And we get a water scroll, so... That's kind of cool. Just kind of a neat little trick there. And I didn't actually know this until one of my last playthroughs of this game, that was actually there. So that's kind of cool. I actually had to do some research to find that out. So I think that's kind of neat. Okay. And that opens that up. Very nice. Okay, and that part's kind of broken, so we can't do anything with that just yet. Okay, so there's what happens if Gao fails on his... dance command there, Water Harmony. So I tried that there and it didn't quite work. But, like I said, my success rate with that has actually been pretty high. I've been pretty impressed with how well I've been able to do with that. So that's kind of cool. Okay. Now they should steal some HP from Mog. Thank you. Very nice. Uh-oh. Now watch out for that glare attack. That can blind you. Yeah. See, Gal's missing today. Or, not today, but in this battle, he's missing. But no problem, sir. We have enough attacks to finish our guys off. And Edgar's learning. Yeah, all of our characters are doing really, really, really well. Gaining levels. Really nice. Okay. Now what we want to do is go over here. Throw this switch. Aha! And that opens that entrance there. And if we go in here, we go in here. Woohoo! Treasure room! And we get a Magicite shard. Now what that does is if you use that in battle, it will summon a random Esper to do something for you. Not particularly useful. Not particularly helpful, but it's there. Whoa! I got the ultimate weapon this early in the game? That's badass! Except that the ultimate weapon, while it looks incredible at this point in the game, is actually not particularly useful. Because, as you can see, the attack power is bound to its wielder's HP. Now, unfortunately, Terra only has 676 maximum HP right now. So she wouldn't actually be able to do a whole lot of damage with it. Now, you know what? I'll demonstrate that. Just so you can... See, it won't even let you equip it as a choice there. You know what will help is if she could actually use it. Mog knows it there. Okay, very good. And might as well take off Gal as well. How are we doing with our espers, by the way? She's still working on Seraph. Good. It's a good idea to check your espers every now and then just to make sure someone learned something, didn't learn anything, and you know, if they were all done and you missed it. Okay, he's still working on float. That's fine. I don't care about that. Okay, so I'll show you ultimate weapon here when we get a chance. But for right now, let's keep on moving. And we'll just keep on moving here. Okay, I want to go this way. Yeah. Throw that switch. That moves that over there. Throw that switch, and that raises that up there. So now I can go across and get a switch inside the chest. Sure. And I'll show you what that does a little bit later on. Okay, so you can see that even with 255 attack power, I only did like 140 damage there, because Terra's HP is not that high. Now, later on in the game, that will be way, way, way different. We're going to be able to do a ton of damage with the ultimate weapon. And it's actually going to be useful for gaining some magic points later in the game. And Terra learned regen. Very good. So, and again, we'll go over that much later. Okay, very good. So let's just go here. All right, we'll take this chest and another Magicite shard. I will never use those. So there you are. And Terra just learned Cura there, so very good. Shielding. Almost. Get her going with Asuna, and then we'll be good to go. All right, let's just go down this way. And we're on the other side! Woohoo! Very nice. And another level for Edgar there. All right, and now we've reached this area, so let me take a second and check my time and do what I need to do, and then we'll be back. Okay, now we're ready to proceed on to the sealed gate, so let's do it. There it is. Oh, by the way, I think I forgot to mention this at the beginning, but you need to have Terra in your party. Otherwise, you won't progress to the sealed gate. The game will say, hey, we need Terra to do this, and they'll make you go back and get her. But for right now, this is the sealed gate. Man, it looks like there's a skull on the door. Wow, these espers weren't very nice people. They must not have wanted anybody here. Don't worry, Terra. It's all you. We have total faith in you. You can do this. No! Kefka! What the hell are you doing here? Terra's gotta open the gate, but can she do it in time? Or will Kefka ruin our plans yet again? You'll have to wait till next time to find out. Till then, this is BCS Buster signing off. Don't forget to like me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter at BCS Buster LP, check out my blog, check out my donations page, and as always, take care, y'all. Stay tuned. This is gonna be intense.